In audio, there are a few ways to talk about sound. The first way is talking technical, like 3 decibels at 1 kilohertz. And the other way is talking with words that we don't all agree upon what it means. For instance, warmth or air. And the last one is the one I want to talk about today while looking at the air EQ from IOSIS. 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 So IOSIS claims that the air EQ is beyond analog, whatever that may mean. It's on their website, it says beyond analog here. It's a simple, intuitive and fast performing air EQ, was designed with a vision of achieving musical, technical and sonic excellence. A lot of buzzwords, of course, but here's where it gets interesting. We've got water and fire, character and strength. What do these parameters mean? I don't know. Character, strength, air, water, ease of use, intuitive. Doesn't say on their website. Do they mean the same with air? As I mean with air. Like an airy mix could also be a mix with a lot of dynamics. New dimension to equalization. Here we can see the different curves. So what those things actually mean are different Q factors. Like fire is a higher Q factor than neutral. And water has a, it's not a lower Q factor, but it has a flat peak. Strange. Earth and air. So we can ground it. Like not technical grounded, but grounded. And air. Bit of a strange thing. Bit of strange names that are being used. So let's test this thing out by running some Sandstorm through it. Of course, Sandstorm. All right, and this is what it looks like. Yeah. So we've got the digital part, which is the upper part, which shows the analyzer. It shows our input and output leveling. And over here, it shows how much we are actually treating, how much dBs are we adding or removing. It's got a very hyperactive spectrum analyzer, which I like to set a bit slower, like relax. It's also got an infinite peak hold in the background. Let's set that one to 10 seconds. Gives us a bit more overview. Now on the bottom, we have a 19-inch piece of equipment. In this case, it's screwed in with a screw, which we call, in Holland, we call it imbus. I don't know what you guys call it in the other side of the world. It's a very annoying screw, because normally if you have a Phillips head, you can remove it also with a flathead screwdriver or a Phillips head screwdriver, which are way more common than the imbus screwdriver. So it's I find it very annoying when equipment is screwed in a rack using inbus. You need to get special tools for that, and most of the times you don't have the correct bit or something. And with a Phillips head, you know, you can get away with different types of screwdrivers. It's not very handy to have that. It does have three-dimensional looking buttons with our perspective point from here. So you can see, we can see the side of the button here and the side of the button over here. It's not necessary that we can see that. And actually the sides also turn, so this is really realistic. Really realistic stuff. Anyway, let's move on to the more serious stuff. So we have a few filters. Let's move through it from left to right through the filter. So first the earth filter. Let's press play. Let's see what happens. So if we look at this curve, you would almost say like this won't work. Like it's most effective at 20 hertz. But if you listen. Very thick, very thick. I like that. I also like the fact that it goes down to 10 hertz. Most EQs start at 20 hertz, which is of course the lowest frequency we can hear, but still. Sometimes I want to go lower than that. I also want to feel something. Then we have a few bell filters. Wait. The game's over here. I love how it pronounces the low frequencies. I like that. Yeah, I really like that. Oh? That's actually not bad. That does sound open to a certain degree. So what do we have more? We have like, these are all the, yeah, these are all the same. So you can, 1, 2, 3, 4, you can add 5 bands. Should be enough, actually 4 bands should be the maximum. High cutting, yeah, this is for high sensitive people that don't like high frequencies. Also 12 decibels per octave. All possible, of course. We do also have a high shelf and a low shelf, which you can use from the first two bands. Yeah, you can shelf them. All right, so this is all basic stuff. What I want to do now is make an EQ curve. Let's go for some kind of a loudness curve. So something like this, and let's see what this thing does to character. Yeah, okay. I was expecting a bit more from that, but maybe it's just me. What does the strength do? Doesn't do nothing at all. Doesn't do anything at all. Why doesn't it do anything? Oh, wait. No. It does something, but we don't get visual feedback from it. You can hear it in the high frequencies. So just make it respond more. So a few other things this thing can do is naming the band. So I can call this one Snake and I can call this one Oil. Really handy if you are working with people that have to control the EQ but actually don't know what to do. Like you can preset the frequencies and just have them control the gain, and you can call the mid band like the voice band or something, voice. Like something like that. Another thing that I really like is if I make this band go to 2 kHz and I make this band go to like here, it's very confusing to work with. Now turning this around is a lot of work, we don't want to do that, but what we can do is rearrange the bands by frequency like that, and now we are arranged again, and now our Oil, Voice, Bell, Snake. Yeah, so those are the basics of this EQ, but does it actually sound different than a FabFilter, for instance? Well, let's find out. So can we replicate this one with FabFilter? And of course, as you know, you can input a sidechain into the FabFilter. So we can already see the difference between the original signal and the red, which is the signal from the Air EQ. Let's press EQ match. Let's say sidechain, and let's wait. All right, let's press match. Now let's keep it simple, because I really want to make the same curve as I did. I don't want to add a lot of extra bands to emulate it. Let's first compare them. So this is the Air EQ we're listening to right now. Another thing to test, putting it out of phase. So let's do a phase comparison between the FabFilter and the Air EQ. So this is the difference between those two EQs, which means that the Air EQ indeed uses a bit of a different algorithm than the FabFilter, and therefore isn't really as much snake oil as you might think. My biggest concern with this EQ is really the user interface. Why is it attached with hexagon screws or Imbus screws or whatever they are called, and not with Phillips screws? I want normal screws. I only want these ones in my rack. These, like Phillips screws. However, what I do like about this EQ is how accessible everything is. In a FabFilter, the controls for every band are hidden, and that's to keep the interface clear, but it's sometimes, you know, it's an extra mouse click away to get to the knobs of the EQ. On the Air EQ, however, everything is directly accessible, which I really, really like about it. The ERIQ sells for $149, which is close to the FabFilter Pro Q2. I know that as I'm posting this video, the Pro Q3 from FabFilter is being released. So I cannot compare it to that one. I'm going to do that while this video is being played on YouTube and making sure that you guys can watch another video tomorrow. It's a bit of time perception over here in my head. $149 for an ERIQ is FabFilter money for an EQ. I do like the character that it can add to your mix bus. I do like the character it could add to a separated sound. So it certainly is an EQ to try out yourself. First try it, then buy it. And it could really help if you want to color your mix more. So it's something very handy to have in your toolbox. And with that being said, I want to end this video over here. If you liked it and have an idea for a future snake oil video, let me know it in the comments below and I will add it to my never-ending list of snake oil plugins. Also, if you want to support my efforts, make sure to check out my Patreon campaign. I will link it over here. Another way to support me is by liking and subscribing or by watching more of my videos, of course. So I will link another one of those over here. Thanks a lot for watching this one and I will see you guys again in the next one. Bye-bye.